A 75-year-old man developed ischemia of the splenic flexure of the colon. Which of the following arteries is most likely blocked? Now, this question deals with the blood supply of the large intestine. Here is the region of the splenic flexure of the colon, or the left colic flexure. The circulation of the large intestine is derived from superior mesenteric artery and the inferior mesenteric artery. Superior mesenteric artery is a branch of the aorta at the level of L1 vertebra, and the inferior mesenteric artery is a branch of the abdominal aorta at the level of L3 vertebra. Also, the rectum derives part of its blood supply from the internal iliac artery. As you can see here, that the superior mesenteric artery supplies part of the small intestine and part of the large intestine. These are the small intestinal branches, the jejunal and ileal branches, and these are the colic branches that supply the large intestine. In fact, the superior mesenteric artery is the artery of the midgut, and the embryologically speaking, the midgut begins at the middle of the second part of the duodenum, including the jejunum, ileum, the cecum, ascending colon, and the proximal two-thirds of the transverse colon, just proximal to the splenic flexure. So all the length of this gut tube is supplied by the superior mesenteric artery, while the inferior mesenteric artery is the artery of the hindgut, and the hindgut starts at the distal third of the transverse colon, including the splenic flexure and the descending sigmoid colon and the rectum, including the upper part of the anal canal. Now, if we look at the choices here, the ileocolic artery is a branch of the superior mesenteric artery. It supplies the cecum and part of the ascending colon because it has ascending and descending branches. The ascending branch anastomosis with a branch of the right colic artery. The right colic artery again has ascending and descending branches, and these branches, they anastomose with the ileocolic and with the middle colic. The middle colic artery is another branch of the superior mesenteric artery. It has right and left branches, and these anastomose with the right colic, and the left branch anastomoses with a branch from the inferior mesenteric artery. The inferior mesenteric artery has a left colic branch that has an ascending branch which supplies the splenic flexure and anastomosis with the left branch of the middle colic artery. Then the inferior mesenteric artery has sigmoidal branches and a superior rectal artery that crosses the pelvic brim and supplies the rectum and the upper part of the anal canal. And as we can see, that both the branches of the superior and the inferior mesenteric artery, they anastomose with each other and form what we call a marginal artery, which is a continuous anastomotic arcade along the mesenteric border of the large intestine. Now, this anastomosis is important because it provides a collateral circulation between the branches of the superior and inferior mesenteric arteries that supply the large intestine. Now, the weakest link in this marginal artery is near the left colic flexure, that is between the middle colic and left colic branches. This is what we call a watershed area. This watershed area is a medical term referring to regions of the body that receive a dual blood supply from the distal branches of two large arteries. For example, here in the splenic flexure of the large intestine, the distal branches are distal branches of the superior mesenteric and distal branches of the inferior mesenteric artery. And at times of blockage of one of these arteries that supply the watershed area, then if this blockage is gradual, then there will be enough time for the anastomosis to provide for the reduced blood supply from the other artery. But in cases of like a systemic hypofunction, for example, in heart failure or disseminated intravascular coagulation. These regions are of the watershed areas are particularly vulnerable to ischemia because of the fact that they are supplied by the most distal branches of the arteries. So they are the least likely to receive sufficient blood supply. Now, returning back to the question, the splenic flexure is part of the hindgut. The hindgut is supplied by a branch of the inferior mesenteric artery, and so it is supplied by the distal branches of the ascending branch of the left colic artery. The correct answer is the left colic artery because, as we have mentioned, the ileocolic supplies the cecum and part of the ascending colon, the right colic supplies the ascending colon, and the middle colic supplies the transverse colon, the part that belongs to the midgut and ends at the distal third of the transverse colon. The left gastroepiploic artery is not related to the colon. In fact, the left gastroepiploic artery is passing along the greater curvature of the stomach. It supplies gastric branches to the stomach and epiploic branches to the greater omentum, that covers the intestine as an apron, but it does not participate in the supply of the large intestine. In fact, the left gastroepiploic artery is a branch of the splenic artery, and this is a branch of the celiac trunk, the artery that supplies the foregut and has nothing to do with the splenic flexure.